Welcome to the Windows Club. A lot of users face the 100417CF access violation error with the USB Wi-Fi adapter. And if you encounter the same error on your computer, then please watch this video. I will guide you through the resolutions one by one. This error is usually encountered with the USB Wi-Fi dongle. So we will try the solutions in a sequential manner. The first solution is to run the Network Adapter Troubleshooter. Right click on the start button and select settings from the menu. In the settings window, go to the system tab on the list on the left hand side. In the right pane, scroll down and click on Troubleshoot. Select other troubleshooters. Now scroll down to the Network Adapter Troubleshooter and click on run corresponding to it. The next solution is to restart the WLAN AutoConfig service. Press the Windows key and the R button together to open the run window. In the run window, type the command services.msc and hit enter to open the service manager window. Scroll down to the WLAN AutoConfig service, right click on it and select restart. It would need a few seconds to restart this service. The next solution will be to update the network drivers on your computer. Right click on the start button and select settings from the menu. In the settings menu, go to the Windows Update tab on the list on the left hand side. In the right pane, select advanced options. Now scroll down to optional updates. If you find any optional updates here, they will be the driver updates. Please install them on your computer. The next solution will be to modify existing power saving options. I'll explain how this is done. Press the Windows key and the R button together to open the run window. In the run window, type the command devmgmt.msc and hit enter to open the device manager window. Now expand the list for universal serial bus controller. Right click on a media dongle related device. Select properties, go to power management and uncheck the box associated with allow the computer to turn off this device to save power. Click on OK. The next solution is to run a few commands. So scroll down to solution number 5 in the original article. The link is in the description section. Copy this list of commands. Search for command prompt in the Windows search bar. Click on run as administrator in the right pane to open the elevated command prompt window. Paste all of these commands here and hit enter after the last command. The next solution will be to run a CHKDSK scan. This has been explained over the associated article. Basically, what you need to do is you need to copy a certain command. So scroll down and copy this command, which is CHKDSK /F. I'll copy it. I'll return to the elevated command prompt window. I'll paste it here and I'll hit enter to initiate the CHKDSK scan. However, you need to remember one thing, that the CHKDSK command will only come into play when you restart your computer. The last solution will be to reset the network settings. Right click on the start button and select settings from the menu. Go to the network and internet tab on the list on the left hand side. In the right pane, scroll down and click on advanced network settings. Now you'll find an option for network reset here. Select this and then click on reset now, this option. This will definitely fix the problem. Isn't this easy and interesting? If you have any doubts, please go to the original article on the Windows Club. Scroll down to the comment section and write your query. We will surely answer to it. Do not forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching this video and have a nice day.